So in this video, we'll discuss about how we can upload blog post, okay, for beginners. So once you have set up your blog or a website on WordPress and log into your dashboard, this is how your website will look up. Okay, so here on the dashboard we have a post. Okay, so in this post you have to go to add new. Okay, so here also you can click. So once you've clicked add new, so then we have options for including your blog post. Okay, first you have to add our title. So now for example, I will take some random topic. Okay, so this is the title, so we have to copy the title and paste it over here. Okay, so then here we have to choose a blog. Okay, so this plus, by clicking this plus button, we have so many options. So if you have to add paragraph, then you have to click this paragraph. Then you can have a heading also, images. Okay, so we have several options over here. We will discuss one by one. So now we have to add a paragraph, right? So now I will just copy paste this paragraph over there. Okay, so now we have to just copy paste it. Okay, so if you want to change the alignment of this paragraph, so what we have to do, we have to just select this, and here these are the basic options available with the WordPress. Okay, WordPress editor, we don't have much options, so we just have right alignment, left alignment and center alignment for our text. We don't have any justification option over here. So if you want to justify your text, or if you want to add color to your text, change the color of your text, or you have to add underline, if you have to add any symbols, then you have to install a plugin. So that plugin I will show you in a moment. Okay, so if you install the plugin, here we will be having so many options. So here we have justify, so we can justify the content which you have pasted here. So if you want to change the color of the font, so then again we have to go here, and here we have options for text color. Okay, we have to click it, and here these are the different options available. Otherwise we can go to this custom color and change the color. Okay, whatever the color you want to have for your text, we can choose it and then apply it to the text. See, now the text color has been changed. Similarly, if you want to add any symbol, so suppose if here if I want to add any symbol over here, then we can go here and here special characters. Okay, so if you are writing a blog post on any mathematical derivations or any technical papers, so in that case this will be very much useful. And so smileys also we can use up. See, if you want to add some symbol like this, we can add over here. Okay, so this way we can use all these options by installing a plugin. I will show you in a moment. Okay, so now next thing, if you want to add any subheading over here, okay, so in that case you have to type in your heading. Okay, so if you click this plus button, we have the option for heading. So if you choose this one, then we will have different ranges for our heading. So this one, so the main heading comes under h1. Okay, this is the main heading, and these are the subheadings. So if you want to write a subheading, this will be heading 2, and another within the subheading, if you want to add another heading, then this font we can use. Okay, so if you click h2 and add some title over here, okay, add some title. Okay, so this this will be h2. Okay, or you can change this as h3 or h4, so accordingly the size of this heading will get changed. Okay, so now if you want to insert any image, so here I have an image over here. Okay, so in a similar way, if you want to insert an image, then you have to choose a block. So click this, so just by entering, this block will come here. So now just by clicking this plus button, we can add image. Okay, so click here and then we have to upload it from our system. So already you should have the figures in your system, then you can upload it easily into your blog post. So now you click this upload option. I have this figure in my system, so we can click this one and it will get uploaded. Okay, so the, once it is uploaded, we can change the size. Okay, so we can change the size of this image. If you want to make it small also, we can make it small, and we can change the alignment also. So if you want to put it in center, or if you want to make it at the right side. Okay, so this alignment can be changed. Okay, this way you can add the images. Okay, so now we have several options also. So if you want to remove this or replace this image, then we have replace option. If you want to remove this block, we have to just click it and delete it. That's all. So it is that simple. And then if you want to add some videos over here, okay, so it is also very simple by using this plus symbol. So we have to click here, and if you want to include a video, then if you want to share some YouTube videos, okay, so we have option for including our YouTube videos also. So you have to click here, and then here we have to enter our URL for the video which you have to include here. So I take this random video, so click the share button. Okay, here we will be having some option for copying our URL, so just we have to copy this and paste it here. Okay, and enter. So that's all, your video will appear here. So it will take a few moments. Okay, this way you can add image. You can add table, you can add quotation also added. Okay, if you click this play button, then it will start playing also. Okay, this way you can embed your videos, YouTube videos here. So at the same time, if you want to write any quotation quotes, okay, so that also we can include over here. We have options for selecting heading, paragraph, okay, images. So if you want to list something, then we have listing option. This bullet points will come, or if you want to give it 1, 2, 3, that also options are available. Okay, so now we'll see the plugin. So how to add the plugin. So finally, once you have done with your draft, you have to click publish. Okay, so once it is published, then only it will become a live post. Okay, now we have the option, our post is published, so we can view our post. Once it is published, our blog post will look like this. Okay, we have the content, it is justified, and we have embedded one video also. Okay, so now we'll see how to add our plugin. So for adding the plugin, you have to go to this dashboard again and go to this plugin. Okay, so here we have installed plugins. So here we can see what are all the plugins already we have installed in our website. Okay, already I have my plugin installed, that is Editor's Kit. Okay, so with the help of this Editor's Kit only, I am doing all the justification and text, font, color change, etc. So if you want to install, then you have to go to add new. Okay, so under plugins, you have to click this add new. Okay, so here, so search, in the search plugins option, you have to type Editor's Kit. Okay, so once you enter this one, you will be having this Gutenberg Block Editor Toolkit. Okay, this is Editor's Kit plugin. So already I have installed it and activated it. Okay, that's why it is showing active. So now in your case, if you have not installed, this will be showing it as install now. Okay, so you have to just click it. Okay, once you click this one, it will get installed. Okay, so once it is installed, you have to click this activate. Okay, so once it is activated, this will be available for you to make alignment in your blog post. Okay, if you go and see in the installed plugins, we can see, okay, this is the plugin which I have shown you. Okay, so already I have my editor's kit plugin, which is very much useful for justifying your blog contents.